'Twas a long time ago, longer now than it seems, in a place perhaps you've seen in your dreams. For the story you're about to be told began in the holiday worlds of old. I know you're curious to see what's inside. It's what happens when two holidays collide. Welcome, my friends, to another episode of Top 5 Disney Haunted Mansion Holiday. As you drag your body into the stretching room of the Haunted Mansion, you might take note of how pleasantly decorated it is. You may also notice the famous stretching portraits have been replaced with a seasonal alternative. Well, what if I told you the original hanging portraits were still there? You see, during the holidays, Jack throws up a type of banner on the original portraits, so behind the festive stained glass windows still hang some of her favorite happy haunts. As you watch on top of a ledge in the ballroom, watching some happy haunts materialize for a swinging wake, to you everything looks the same, besides from all the merry and the gingerbread house that looks quite scary. Look behind the Christmas tree and you will notice a library. You will only be able to see this during the holidays, and it's also a fun little Easter egg that adds something a little bit special to the holiday incarnation of the Haunted Mansion. When you're taking your tour through the now festive mansion, during your tour you might notice that a familiar face, or should I say crow, is missing from the mansion. Well, during the holidays he flies off to do whatever crows do during the holidays, but while he is away, he leaves us a little friend, a terrifying teddy bear, which is one of the gifts Jack generously gives two children in the Nightmare Before Christmas film. Until Jack flies away with his reindeer in his sleigh, the terrifying teddy bear is here to stay. Besides Tokyo Disneyland, the only place you can experience Haunted Mansion Holiday is at Disneyland. Unfortunately, the Magic Kingdom does not have an iteration of the Haunted Mansion Holiday, and the original attraction is present all year long. The reason for this is that most of Disneyland's guests are locals, but most of Walt Disney World's guests are people who see a trip to Walt Disney World a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And if this is the only trip you might ever take to Walt Disney World, you don't want to miss out on all the famous and classic Disney attractions. But just because there's no Haunted Mansion Holiday in Magic Kingdom does not mean there's no Nightmare Before Christmas references scattered around the ride, as there are 13 Easter eggs scattered around these haunted halls. Only about half of them have been found, with the others still hiding somewhere in the mansion. So if you have a sharp eye, maybe you could be the one to find all the other Easter eggs. Earlier in the video, I mentioned of a gingerbread house that looks quite scary. Well, what if I told you the happy haunts make a new gingerbread house every year? For example, if you rode Haunted Mansion Holiday in 2017 and feasted your eyes on Jack's gingerbread house, you will never see that gingerbread house ever again. And that's because we got a new gingerbread house this year in 2018. And when Jack returns to the mansion next year in 2019, you will see the ghosts have baked up a brand new surprise. Also, a bonus fact, that is a real gingerbread house, it's not fake, which shows you how far Disney is willing to go. So that's the Haunted Mansion Holiday, an attraction that I highly recommend if you are ever at Disneyland during the holidays, and an attraction that in my opinion is almost as good as the original ride, and to some, better than the original ride. So if you're a fan of the Nightmare Before Christmas or the Haunted Mansion, it is not to miss. Anyway, I'd like to thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch this video, and I will see you all a little later. Come out!